today.
Yes.
Lord has blessed us with a beautiful day. We have one of our members back that we haven't seen in almost a year. Amen. So glad to have her back. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So glad to see each and every one of you. Amen. Amen. Right now we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. Amen. And if there's anyone who has a spoken request, you can stand now or let it be known by raising your hand. Amen. Evangelist Aaron.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. This pandemic that we're in, that this, yes, these shots will help.
Amen.
And we can get back to a little normalcy. Amen.
Right.
Amen. 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 Pray that God will save and add to the church daily such as should be saved. Pray for the body of Christ everywhere.
Everywhere.
It's just a dropping off everywhere.
Yeah.
It seems that I thought the pandemic would bring people closer to God.
Yeah.
But it seems that they just don't have a desire. Amen. So pray for the world. You know, if you were out there, you would want them to pray for you. I would want them to pray for me. So let's pray for the dying world. Pray that God will give them minds to be saved before it's too late. Ask everyone to stand, please. Let every heart pray. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. We come, Lord, to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We come, Lord, thank you for waking us this morning, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Being clothed in our right mind.
Hallelujah.
With a mind to serve you, Lord, as never before.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you and praise you, Lord, for all the souls that have come this morning.
Yes,
to lift up and magnify your name, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We come to praise you, Lord.
Praise
you're worthy of all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And we come just to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Lord, we come to show you that we're grateful. We're thankful.
For
all that you've done for us, Lord. For all that you're doing for us, Lord. For all that you're going to do for us, oh God. We ask you, Lord, that you'll bless the body of Christ, Lord Jesus. Oh, asking that you'll save, Lord, and to the churches there, such as should be saved. Send in helps from your churches, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we're asking that you look on our leaders, our pastors, our bishops, Lord. We're asking that you'll bless them, Lord. favorite passages of Scripture?
Yes, Lord.
And it reads, the Lord is my light and my salvation.
Yes, Lord.
Whom shall I fear?
Yes.
The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes came upon me to, I don't have my reading glasses on. I'm going to ask the reader to come up. I just thought I put the wrong glasses on. David Bills, come on up and read the scripture for me. Thank you, Jesus. It's like these words are all going together.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Yes.
Whom shall I fear?
Yes.
The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?
Yes.
When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat of my flesh, they stumbled and fell.
Yes.
Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear.
Yes.
Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident.
Mm-hmm.
One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after.
Yes.
That I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple.
Alright.
In verse 5, for in the time of trouble,
yes,
he shall hide me,
yes,
in his pavilion.
Yes.
In the secret of his tabernacle,
yes,
shall he hide me.
Yes.
He shall set me up upon a rock.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I should have had this Bible. You should have seen how big those words were. Yeah.
So I think praise God is just a great, great blessing when you have somebody pray. around.
Thank you.
Like grown-ups, to display the love and the mercy and grace he has for everybody. And y'all be able to see that. People ask the adults around you. So the last one is, and whoso shall receive one such little child in my name receives me. So, Pastor and the whole church receiving y'all, we will get blessed by the Creator and the Savior by acknowledging y'all and teaching y'all and coaching y'all and walking with y'all. So I just want to say, just keep striving. It's going to be better days, and it might seem hard. Y'all might seem like y'all friends ain't involved in church. Y'all separated, y'all feel lame or not cool or hip. It's all right, because y'all like when you're separate and separated. You don't always be covered. All my friends are dead or jail, or 30 people.
My God.
I'm not even 30. 30 people, I'm not 30, is dead or in jail for life, and I will never see. But I've been working with God since I was y'all age, and I'm wonderful. So y'all got to take it one day.
I'm not tired yet, and I don't see no other option. option for me than to just run on and see what the end's going to be. Amen? Amen. I want to see what the end of this thing is going to be. I've been hearing it, and you've been hearing it for so long that the Lord is coming soon. And it's been 45 years, and he still hasn't came. But you know what? He's coming. And I believe it will be soon. Amen? We don't know. An evangelist came to the church one time and he said, I know when the Lord is coming. And I sat there and I said, now look, no man don't know when the Lord is coming. And he said, I know when he's coming. And everybody said, well, when? He said, at a time you think not. So, and that's the truth. The scripture says he's coming at a time you think not. So you can go, don't get comfortable over here, amen. Don't let your mind just go wherever you want to go, amen. Because he's going to catch you with your work undone if you do that. So he's coming at a time we think not. So it behooves us to get ready and stay ready. Amen. But when the saints go marching in, Lord, I want to be in that number. I want to crown, I want to be there when they crown him Lord of Lords. And when we all march around that throne. Amen. Hallelujah. Everybody, there's another song say, I'm going to tell them all about my troubles. No, you're not. You ain't going to think about no troubles when you see Jesus. Amen. If anything, you just want to see his face. Amen. The one who died for you. The one who set you free. The one who gave you a mind to run on through it all. Amen. The one who kept you down through the years. You just want to see his face. Amen. So don't believe that you're going to tell them all about your troubles. You're going to forget every trouble you ever had when you see Jesus. I heard somebody say this morning, if I could just get my foot in the door, amen. I don't care what I do, just let me get my foot in the door, amen. Amen. I want to hear that heavenly choir. I want to see Enoch and Elisha. I want to know where they've been all this time, amen. I want to know what Enoch's testimony was, that he pleases God, amen. What a testimony. That God will translate you from death because of your testimony. Amen. I guess the prayer of Jabez was nothing compared to his testimony. Amen. Amen. But we just want to live right so we can see Jesus. Amen. We just want to do what's right so we can see Jesus. Amen. Amen. Is there another testimony to the Lord? One last call. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Alright,
we
have another one. Amen. Praise him.
Alright.
You have to go to these churches.
Thank you, Jesus.
See what was going on. See what churches didn't minister to you. See what churches didn't have spirit in. It's really the people, that's not a testimony. It's really the people that keep the spirit in the church. Mm. But she said it's different from looking on Facebook and coming in. Mm. It's totally different from because it's the presence of God.
Thank you, Lord.
It's the presence of God. We have to always acknowledge the presence of God, whether it's being on Boston Journeys, private missions, or dealing with people on an everyday life.
Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing I've ever done. How many believe that?
Oh, yeah.
I know that. Now, that's the other end of my testimony. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I ever done. I thought falling in love with my husband was the best thing I've ever done. I thought getting a nice home was the best thing I'd ever done.
Come on.
I thought getting a brand new car, amen, in 2004 was the best thing that I'd ever done. Amen. I thought when I got my first big diamond ring with all the bling, that was the best thing I ever done.
Come on.
But you know what? The older I get, the more I realize that falling in love with Jesus was the best thing that I'd ever done. Amen? Ever since that wonderful day when I met him, that was it. Amen? I didn't need anything else. I didn't want anything else. Amen? But all the other benefits came. Because I sought the kingdom and its righteousness first. Amen? So anything that you need from God today, if you seek the kingdom and its righteousness first, he said all those other things you'll just add. Amen? He already knows what you want. He already knows what you need. It's just a matter of you seeking him. Amen? Amen? And at a time when you think not, he'll give you exactly what you've always requested. If you meditate on his word day and night, he said, he'll give you the desires of your heart.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And I found God to be a true God. Amen.
Yes.
You know how sometimes people tell you things and you might believe it, or it might happen, they might do it, or something might happen and they might not be able to do it.
Uh-huh.
But God never changes.
Yes.
If it's in this book, he will do it.
Yes.
If it's written, he will bring it to pass.
Yeah.
Amen. But we have to do our part. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
A lot of us go after things before we go after God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But we have to go after God so that he can give us the things.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So he knows when we're ready for the things.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And we have to learn how to give.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. If this fist is closed up, right?
Uh-huh.
Ain't nothing go out of it. Nothing don't come in.
Yeah.
But once we become a liberal soul,
yes,
once we give, we start giving, then God will bless you with the things that you have asked him for.
Yes,
amen. But sometimes he don't give you those things because he has to teach you how to give.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
I remember looking at the offering one Sunday and somebody go by and they put a dollar in the basket.
My Lord.
And Dollar General even have false advertisement now because you can't go there and get nothing for a dollar.
Nothing.
You know, I'm like, y'all need to change this sign to dollars and more, amen? Or something, amen? So when you come to give your offering and your tithes to the Lord, make sure it's an offering, amen? Not something just left over, amen? Yeah, we're going to start taking my offering in a minute, and I just want to boost your faith concerning what God can do for you.
Amen.
I remember a time when I didn't have much. I had 7 children, and I was working a little job, and it didn't pay much, you know.
Uh-oh.
And my husband, he had a good job, but we had bills, amen, so it was going out.
Yeah.
And I was sitting there thinking, well, I paid all my bills because I was a person that liked to pay my bills and pay them on time, and I didn't like to go to bed worrying about things. So
right.
I had $14 left.
Uh-oh.
And I sat there and I said, Lord, what am I going to do? I said, I guess I get a pack of beans, a pack of pack of peas, get some spaghetti, get a pack of chicken. You know, I'm figuring it out because back in those days, things weren't as expensive as they are now.
Right.
So I had my little $14 figured out. By that time, here comes somebody. Bum, bum. Big van, amen? Jesus. This person bought me in like 8-9 bags of groceries.
What you doing?
And I said, I was just sitting there trying to figure out what I'm going to do with $14. And here you come. She said, well, the Lord told me everything, and I just bought for myself. Amen. But it's a virtual conference. It's the PCMAF INC or something. INT, not TL. Not TL. Oh, Lord. Y'all just keep living. Amen. Just keep living. Amen. But it's going to be a virtual conference, and it's going to be February 27th through the 24th through the 27th. So let's keep that in mind. Amen.
Amen.
And I think it starts at 7.
Yes.
7 p.m.
Yeah.
Amen. All right. And I don't know if we're going to, are we having prayer Friday? Prayer
Friday. I'm sorry. Not this Friday. I made a mistake because that's when the conference starts.
All right. All right. All right. No prayer this Friday.
Yeah.
Amen. And we'd like to extend a hearty welcome to all of our guests and friends. Amen. We'd like to let you know that you're always welcome to worship with us here. Christian Ministries. Amen.
Amen.
Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce our pastor. Let's receive Bishop Frankie L. Quinn with a hearty amen.
You're doing an awesome job, Pastor Doug. Let's give of the Lord one more time. Amen.
Amen.
David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
He said, let us enter in his gates with thanksgiving and in his courts with praise.
Yes.
And it is good for us to be here. And it's good for us to magnify the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And we certainly do give honor to whom honor is due. We praise God for our First Lady, Lady Tracy Quinn. Pastor Duck, and we thank God for the ladies and deacons. And we certainly do thank God for our ushers and our deacon team. Amen. We thank God for all of you that are here on today. We certainly praise God for each and every one of you as God has blessed us. We thank God for our sanitation committee that comes in and sanitizes this area every other week. We have professionals that come in and do it for us. And we thank God for our ushers. We spray down everything after service and wipe down everything. We praise Him. We thank God for those that come and take the temperatures and give out the masks. And we praise God for that.
Amen.
We thank God for you wearing your mask.
Amen.
Y'all heard all the commercials and things like that. You gotta have it above your nose as you're wearing your mask. And also, you know, when you're singing and testifying, keep your mask on.
Yes.
Amen. We don't want no particles coming out. I know with me, I know how I get. So, you know, we want you to continue to wear your mask properly.
Above your nose,
even when you're singing and testifying.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Cautious and of those that are around us, and we as we gear up to take those shots, those vaccines, and get all that herd immunity going. Hopefully, we'll be back to normal sometime next year.
Yeah.
But I praise God, everything in His own time. Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you. And we praise God, and also my mindset. This is my faith. And I'm saying this. I want y'all to have this kind of faith too. You know how God, when the children of Israel were down there in Egypt, and the plague was riding up over, and people in Egypt were dying, but the children of Israel weren't, because they were in the land of Goshen, a city of protection and safety.
Yeah.
That's why I'm asking the Lord, Lord, keep us in Goshen.
Yeah.
Keep us in a city of protection and safety.
Yes.
Amen. I can dwell, you can dwell there by faith.
Yes.
You can dwell there by believing God.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, that the Lord will keep us and watch over us.
Yes.
Amen. So that that virus can pass over us. Amen.
Hallelujah.
But in the meantime, I'm still going to wear my mask. I ain't going to tip God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So let us be mindful of these things. Amen. And ushers, y'all have permission to speak to the people. Amen. To encourage them. Pull up your mask if you see it coming down. So we thank God, as Pastor Duck was making mention of the PCAFI, The conference, that's the organization that we're involved in. They have the conference this week, and you can go online and register. Registration is $25. And the conference is called a LEAD conference, and I forget what those acronyms stand for at this moment, but it's a lot of teaching and empowerment to help us. Amen. And so you'll have access to those services and those meetings. The night services are free, but they have lined up dynamic preachers for us to enjoy. Amen. So let us gear ourselves up. And I may mention about prayer on Friday, since that conference, I forgot that the conference was on Friday, and I have to be in attendance based on my status with the organization. So we won't have prayer this Friday, but we'll resume it on next Friday.
Amen.
If the Lord will, if Jesus don't come first. So we certainly praise God. How many of you just praise God?
Amen.
The Lord is good, and His mercy endured forever. And I want you to turn with me just for a brief moment in time. Thank you, Lord. I praise Him, and we pray that God will continue to bless us as we grow. Bless us with musicians, and bless us with singers.
Amen.
Bless us with everything that we need.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. In fact, He's already blessed us. Let's pray for the manifestation of these things.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We certainly do praise and thank God for your sacrifice, and those that are tuning in with us, even on Facebook Live, we thank God for you all as well. And there's also an avenue to give virtually, and that's through our tithing.
Yeah.
Amen. People tremendously utilize that, and we thank God for that avenue. And you just find us on Tithely, Christian Ministries of the Apostolic Faith Church. Go through the process, and then you'll be able to give. And we thank God for giving.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible says it's more blessed to give than to receive. And I thank God also, too, for the testimonies that I've heard on today, and the songs of Zion. The testimonies and the songs of Zion tremendously go with our sermon on today. One that sticks out in my mind with Evangelist Arrington. I don't know if y'all was listening to her. She got her a mini sermon in there. Talking about the Lord comforting. Gave her peace, and then she sang that song, Lived and He Loved Me.
Yeah.
Hey, hallelujah. She got her a sermon in there. So we thank God for the word. I mean, thank God for the word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So we want you to stand with us and go to the book of Romans. Romans chapter number 1. And Romans chapter number 1. When you have it, say amen. Oh, thank you, Lord. Help me here, Holy Ghost. Yes, Lord. Romans chapter number 1. And verses, drop down to verses 16 and 17. Romans 16 and 17. Amen. Lord, add me to add that verse. I got to be obedient to the Spirit. Romans number 1, verses 16. 17. It says as thus, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. For as it is written, the just shall live by faith.
Yes.
Let us read that together. Can we read that together? For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written,
The just shall live by faith. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this hour. We thank you for this time of preaching. We thank you for this time of revelation, this time of revealing of your word and manifestation of your grace and of your mercy. We ask you, Lord, that you bless me, your servant. Bless these thy great people. Send forth your word, Lord, and we know that it won't return unto you void, but it will accomplish whereunto it is sent. And Lord, we thank you. Make preaching easy. Clarity of thought. Hallelujah. Clarity of thought and speech. Father, we thank you and we praise you in the precious and the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And just by way of reading again in your hearing, it says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith." And I just want to take a thought this morning with you. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. And anyone that has read the scriptures understand that Paul himself was persecuted for believing in Jesus Christ. The Bible says that he hazarded his life for the preaching of Christ. He was beaten, he was talked about, he was scourged, and this was all for the furtherance of the gospel. He was thrown in jail, in prison, oftentimes. And many of his letters, he encouraged the saints of God, "Don't be despondent or don't be discouraged by my bonds, because what I'm going through is going through for the furtherance of the gospel. What I'm going through is going to help you if you continue to believe and to trust in the Lord." Paul became so excited about crucifixion and about his suffering that he had to look at it another way. He said that he was crucified with Christ, that nevertheless he lived. He said, "Yet not I, but Christ liveth in me." And he realized that the life that I now live in this flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God. Paul realized that what he was going through in his persecution, he had to flip it in his own mind to make him believe and to understand that the trials and the tribulations that he were facing, it worked for our good. It worked toward his mission. It worked toward his purpose. It worked toward the things that God had called him for. That's why the Bible says for us to count it all joy when you go through diverse temptations. Your perspective means everything. Your perspective means everything. You don't need to have a pity party just because you're going through. Your ideas and the thoughts in your mind should be, "I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth." And though you are persecuted, Paul said, "Though I'm persecuted, I'm not cast down. Though I'm going through, I'm not destroyed." And he realized that what he was going through and the situation that he was enduring, it was for a greater purpose. A greater purpose. And that was for the furtherance of the gospel by which he himself has given himself unto. And that's why, you know, Paul was excited about persecution. He was excited about the things that he was going through. And also, too, with persecution, you got to realize that also Paul himself, he turned around before he got saved. He was persecuting the saints. And then sometimes karma will come back on you. You reap what you sow. Thank you, Jesus. He was persecuting the saints. So he realized what persecution could do to an individual because he himself was a persecutor. And if we're honest with ourselves, and some of you all that I'm looking at today, Though you're in the good ship and though you're on the Lord's side, you may have persecuted some saints in your whole lifetime. Hallelujah. But God has got you on the right side now. And Paul said he did it ignorantly, not fully realizing what he was doing. A lot of times we say some things and we do some things that we don't fully realize and understand what we're doing. But in the long run, we thank God that he had mercy upon us. He had mercy upon us. I'm reminded self-exposure as a time when my wife and I, we were dating, but she was in the church. She was going to the church, and you know, I was kind of far away from the church, and she said she had to go to a meeting, and I told her, well, you got to choose between me and God. And my God, I'm so glad God didn't foreclose on me. Yes, I'm gonna go shout. If nobody shout, I'm gonna shout right now. I'm so glad God didn't put a knot on my head. I mean, I'm so glad that God didn't strike me. Come on, Mr. God. I mean, you know I was talking ignorant. I was saying what I was saying without knowledge. I mean, I was saying what I was saying. I'm so glad that God is a God of a second chance. Aren't you glad that God is a God of a second chance? I'm glad that he's a God of a second chance. I'm glad God gave us another opportunity. And that's what God did for Paul. He gave him another opportunity and gave him an opportunity to realize that Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to him. When you turn your life over to Jesus, you come to realize that he's the best thing that ever happened to you. My God, when you turn your life over to Jesus, he gives you joy. He gives you peace. He makes your sad days happy days. And then you come to a realization that I won't complain. Because God is on your side. And you come to a realization that Jesus is the best thing that has ever happened to you. It changes your life. It makes your life more better. And that's when Paul realized that his life was for the better. Amen. Though the trials may come, though the tribulations may come back, though situations may happen, hallelujah to you. Thank you, Lord. But you realize that Jesus, without the Lord on your side, if it had not been for the Lord, if it had not been for Jesus, if it had not been for that lily of the valley and the lightning stone and star, if it had not been for the Lord that is keeping us and watching over us, hallelujah, we wouldn't be where we are right now. Because we know that every day with Jesus, can you just testify of your own self? Just that every day with Jesus is better than the day before. Aren't you glad that he died? Aren't you glad that he rose again? Aren't you glad that he visited you in your midnight hour? Aren't you glad that he woke you up this morning and he started you on your way? Oh my God, I feel like praising him. Hallelujah. I feel like magnifying the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. If it had not been for the Lord on our side, when I think of the goodness of Jesus, of all that he has done for us, not just me, of all that he has done for us, our soul. Jesus. When you fully realize what we ought to praise him.
Sure.
This is the have in Christ. Hallelujah. And it's revealed to you by faith. What Jesus did for us, he saved us from sin, from the power of sin, from the penalty of sin. He saved us from the wages of sin. Oh, because the wages of sin is death. When you realize that this gospel message, Jesus said, I am the resurrection. I am the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And he that liveth, what you are right now, you're living and you're believing. He said, and you shall never die. Believest thou this? That's the key. You gotta believe. You gotta believe. You gotta believe that he is who he said he is. You gotta believe that he can do what he said he can do. When you believe and you trust in him, don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Because sometimes you may be placed in a situation wherein the Lord is with you, but he's making an example of it. And you may feel like, Lord, why have you left me here? But the Bible says he will never leave me. He will never forsake me. The Bible says that this light of affliction, which is just before God, and working for us, a far more exceeding and eternal way of glory. You got to realize that you're God's witness. And if you're the witness, you got to be able to witness to what? Witness to his power. Witness that he's a healer. Witness that he's a deliverer. Witness that he's a comforter. Witness that he can give you joy in the midst of your storm. Can I get a witness? Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Pastor Doug testified earlier, said, yes, he had to put all her money on pills and didn't have too much food in the cupboard. But she wasn't ashamed to tell you all of what God had done for her. After the most shock, don't be ashamed to say what God has done for you. He woke you up this morning. He started you on your way. He put joy in your heart. Don't be ashamed. Don't be ashamed. Tell your neighbor, I'm not ashamed. I wasn't ashamed to tell you. Hallelujah. But I told my wife, you gotta choose between her and me and God. Hallelujah. Though that was foolish. Hallelujah. But I'm so glad. I said, I'm so glad. And I said, I'm shocked. Now he looked beyond all my faults. He looked beyond all your faults. And he sees your need. Because of the gospel of Jesus Christ, all of your sins have been paid. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All of that. Who looked in Revelation here now? Because every time I think of that story, I repent. Hallelujah. And Jesus just said, I've already paid for that. You can move on. Yeah. Hallelujah. Forgetting those things that are behind. Reaching for those things that are before. There is some more stuff you did in your life. But when you came to Jesus, he washed you. He cleansed you. He purified you. Forgetting those things that are behind. Don't let that dirty presence hold you back. Don't let that foolish stuff that you did in your life hold you down. You've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Come on and give God a praise.
God, it gives the commandments.
live, the just shall walk by faith. Hallelujah. Faith in what? Faith in Jesus. Faith in all that he's done. Faith in that he is my Savior. Faith in that he died for me. Not only did he die, he was buried for me. Not only was he buried, but he rose again for me. And that he ascended up on high. And he led captivity captive. And he gave the gifts unto men. And he ascended and sat down at the right hand of power and of God. Now that's my faith. And that my faith says he's conquered. He conquered the devil. My faith says he's conquered hell. My faith says he's conquered disease. My faith says that he conquered death. Hallelujah, that nothing by any means shall harm us. Nothing by any means shall destroy us. If you put your trust in Jesus, he said the man shall be as a hiding place, a shelter in the time of the storm. Hallelujah, that's why when the storms of life come to our house, they don't blow us off that rock because we've got an anchor. Somebody tell your neighbor, I've got an anchor. And it's holding me steadfast. Is it holding you steadfast? Are you unmovable? Will you always abound in the work of the Lord? For as much as you know your neighbor, he's not in vain. Come on and give the Lord a praise. I said all that to say this. My God. It's not by your works that you were saved. It's not by your works or your deeds that you've been delivered. It's by your faith in Jesus. It's by your faith in the Messiah. It's by your faith in the Son of the living God. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Let the church stand. Hallelujah. Lift them, he loved me.
Before his presence,
the only exceeding wise God. To him be glory.